Much of the official narrative around the convicted paedophile Jeffrey Epstein doesn't quite stack up. But it's the official story around his death that is perhaps the most fishy. Epstein was the most high-profile prisoner on Earth, with potentially many secrets about the world's most powerful people. However, locked away in the best-funded prison system in the world, Epstein, in August 2019, was still able to hang himself. Now, a big element of the supposed mishaps that led to Epstein's death involved two prison guards, Tova Noel and Michael Thomas. Now, Nova and Thomas were supposed to check on Epstein every 30 minutes. However, they instead slept and browsed the internet. They then went on to falsify prison records to hide the fact they had failed to check on Epstein for a period of over 2 hours. So they were guarding the most high-profile prisoner on Earth to stop him killing himself, because this is a guy, you know, we really want to see him have his day in court. They fall asleep, they browse the internet, they don't check on him. Whoopsie daisy, he's dead. Now, in a development that will surprise no one, these two guards, who didn't do their job very well and then falsified records, have been spared jail time in a deal with federal prosecutors. As part of the deal with prosecutors, they will enter into a deferred prosecution agreement with the Justice Department and will serve no time behind bars. Noel and Thomas would instead be subjected to supervised release, would be required to complete 100 hours of community service, and would be required to fully cooperate with an ongoing probe by the Justice Department's Inspector General. The two have admitted that they willfully and knowingly completed materially false count and round slips regarding required count and rounds in the housing unit where Epstein was being held. So they falsified the documents that said, we've done the round, we've visited the prisoners. They said they'd done it. They hadn't done it. So what's happened here? They said, oh, you know, if you work with us, you don't have to go to prison for this, even though it led to the death of the world's most high-profile prisoner, and it would have actually been in the interest of lots of people to have, you know, a proper case. Now, not everyone is happy with this result. According to AP, Senator Ben Sasse, who is a Republican member of the Senate Judiciary Committee, called the deal unacceptable and said the public deserves to see a report detailing the prison agency's failures. 100 hours of community service is a joke. This isn't traffic court, Sasse said in a statement. The leader of an international child sex trafficking ring escaped justice. His co-conspirators had their secrets go to the grave with him, and these guards are going to be picking up trash on the side of the road. Now, of course, it's not inconceivable that this was all a cock-up. The article goes on to say that these were two members of staff who were incredibly overworked. They'd been forced, essentially, to do lots of overtime. One of them had another job. You know, I don't envy these people. I'm also not really in favor of people going to jail because they fell asleep on the job because they've been worked too hard by their bosses. But the broader context of the death and the circumstances around it mean I'm not particularly willing to take this deal at face value. In a moment, I'm going to explain to you why. I'm going to remind you of the unanswered questions when it comes to Epstein's death. But first, lots of you watching will not be subscribed. So if that's you and you're enjoying this video, hit subscribe for more Novara content. Now let's go through the quick timeline of why I'm not necessarily convinced that all is above board when it comes to this deal, and why, I mean, there's lots of reasons to be suspicious when it comes to the suicide of Jeffrey Epstein. By the way, this is not me being particularly tinfoil hat. The majority of Americans believe this was not a suicide. It's quite mainstream. Now let's go through why everyone thinks this. So on the 6th of July, 2019, in the midst of the Me Too scandal, Epstein was arrested for multiple counts of sex trafficking minors. You probably know that part of the story. Now, these were the same crimes he had been let off lightly for a decade earlier. He managed to get, you know, amazing deals with federal prosecutors, actually state prosecutors in Florida. They were essentially swept under the rug. He did a few months in a prison where he essentially got to hang out in his own house. The whole thing's completely ridiculous. But in the midst of the Me Too scandal, he gets arrested. He goes to proper prison, and now the world's eyes are watching. They can't just sweep it under the rug. And many people were worried that Epstein was going to get killed in jail because he knew lots of secrets about very powerful people. Indeed, in the summer of 2018, Epstein told a New York Times journalist he had dirt on multiple powerful people. So this is in his own words, he got lots of dirt on lots of powerful people. A month before his supposed suicide, he was found injured after allegedly being strangled by his cellmate, the multiple murder and drug conspiracy suspect, Nicholas Tartaglione. So you've got someone who is, we know, who's got lots and lots of very interesting information that would be useful to law enforcement about lots of powerful people. Who do they put him in jail with? Someone who is suspected of multiple murder and drug conspiracy. Now, this sounds to me, that's what people who are involved in organized crime go to prison for, right? Multiple murder and drug conspiracy charges. Nicholas Tartaglione. It sounds a bit ridiculous that you put him in jail with that guy if you don't want the guy to die. Now, the prison authorities have, I don't want to smear Tartaglione, the prison authorities have cleared him, and they say Epstein himself was responsible for his injuries. Again, you can make up your own mind if that's particularly plausible. However, that same month, lawyers representing Epstein's victims, they weren't convinced either. They told The Sun that they were worried Epstein would be killed before his case would come to trial. Now, it was at this point, after he'd been found strangled either by himself or his cellmate, it was at this point that Epstein was put on suicide watch, but following a psychiatric examination, he was removed from 24-hour surveillance after just 6 days. Then, after being taken off suicide watch, Epstein was placed in the security housing unit. The jail had informed the Justice Department that he would have a cellmate, because that's one way that you can stop people killing themselves, and that a guard would look into the cell every 30 minutes. He was given no cellmate, and you already know the guards did not check him every 30 minutes. That's what that AP story was about. They're not going to jail, even though they didn't look at him every 30 minutes, and they lied to say they did. Now, this is all looking pretty suspicious. It's all very, very circumstantial, though. The biggest clincher for me, and what wasn't mentioned in that AP story, is the guards were asleep. And maybe they were overworked, maybe that's why they were asleep. But outside the cell, there were three cameras. Two of them were broken, with no explanation as to why they were broken. And the third has footage that was unusable. So you've got a situation where we are supposed to believe that the guy with the most dirt on the world's rich and powerful of sort of, anyone you can think of, who knows more than Jeffrey Epstein when it comes to compromising material, be hard to name many people. He's in jail in New York. It's not some backwater place, right? And he manages to kill himself with no guards checking him and with a load of broken CCTV cameras nearby. As I say, I don't want these guards to go to prison, the guards that I started this story with. At the same time, the fact that they've got this deal seems quite convenient for everyone involved. Ash, am I being conspiratorial, or do you see the same gaps in the official narrative that I do?
I don't see so much gaps in the official narrative as a grand canyon of murder. That's what I see. Look, people are free to make up their minds however they want, but I've always been somewhat wary of that truism that cock-up is always more likely than conspiracy, because sometimes actually it's not. In order to make this plausibly a suicide, that could happen despite suicide watch, despite the fact that he was supposed to be assigned a cellmate, despite the fact that there were supposed to be three cameras trained on his cell at all times. Well, that means a chain of causality, which is so infinitesimally improbable that I can't get my head around it, because I can imagine one of these cock-ups happening, the guards, scrolling on their phones or doing whatever, being so tired that they couldn't check on him. But that, plus the fact that he hadn't been assigned the cellmate that he was supposed to have, I could imagine one of the cameras not working, just being broken by sheer chance, but all three cameras. So for all these things to line up neatly, like ducks in a row, and then Jeffrey Epstein taking his life without any coercion, pressure, or outside interference, I find it difficult to get my head around. And if this wants to, be received by Guido or the Daily Mail as evidence of the tinfoil-hatted conspiracist left, go for it. But I do not think that this man made up his own mind to kill himself without any help.
A strong argument against the conspiracy theories is Occam's razor. Potentially the simplest answer is the correct one. The problem in this case is that the simplest like explanation is he was murdered, because the explanation that it was just cock up after cock up after cock up after cock up after cock up, that's now more improbable. It's a more complicated explanation than that he had some dirt on powerful people and the powerful people arranged it so that he would have no chance to reveal that dirt. Like Occam's razor says Epstein murdered.